Hi everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making biryani masala recipe. Biryani masala is an essential spice mix to make any kind of biryani flavorful. There are so many versions of making biryani masala, but in today's recipe we are gonna be blending 14 special spices perfectly for your perfect biryani every time. Please guys do check out my latest Hyderabadi chicken kachi biryani recipe. So guys, let me show you how to make biryani masala today.
Start with the spice that needs the longest cooking time first. So basically we are doing dry roasting. So in a dry tawa, add coriander seeds and start roasting. Saute it. Keep the flame low while roasting. It may take more time, but the goal is to roast them through. You may hear a little popping sound as the whole spices roast. Toss it multiple times so that the seeds can be roasted evenly, and also keep sauteing to avoid burning. Don't over toast the coriander. Toss them around 1 or 2 minutes or until they begin to look toasted and start to jump in the pan. Heat the spices on low flame so that the spices can get even heat to the center without burning the spices. When the color changes to a slightly golden brown, put them in the one side of the pan. Now add jeera and fennel seeds. Roast them also in the same pan. The spices will splatter and release fresh aroma to resist. Now add the whole red chilies. Saute them similarly. All the ingredients list are given in the description below. Please check them out. So when the spices will roast nicely, take out in a plate. Now in another batch of roasting, add cinnamon sticks, stir anise, black cardamom, few green cardamom pods, black peppercorns and cloves. Roast them similarly. They will also release a nice aroma and fill the air with fantastic flavor. Toss it multiple times. After 1 minute of roasting, now add mace, one whole turmeric, one nutmeg, broken into 2 to 3 pieces. Roast them also on low flame. Now we'll put the spices that take less time to roast, like one bay leaf, biryani flour, also known as stone flour, and dried rose petals. Just stir them up. Add salt for seasoning, it's totally optional. Addition of little salt keeps the masala fresh for a long time and also season the spices. After roasting, transfer them also in a same plate. Leave it aside for sometimes like about half an hour until they cool down. Well roasted spices will be very crispy and crunchy. It will be powdered once you press in fingers, as I am showing you now. Once cooled down, put in a blender jar. Now grind them into a fine powder. Now the whole spices blended nicely. Sometimes it can have big pieces of ungrounded spices, so it's better to save it. After sieving, store in an airtight container. Basically, I made a paper cone and put in the container so that the masala can go in without scattering on the ground. So our biryani masala is ready. You can use it in any biryani or even use it in any veg or non-veg curries to make the dishes more tastier and flavorful.
I hope you guys enjoyed watching this biryani masala recipe. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share it with your family and friends, And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care and bye.